So far, you've seen that you can trap for exceptions in your code, and you can take advantage of a number of exception classes to trap for specific errors. In this section, you'll see how you can create your own type of exception by creating your own exception class, and you'll also see that you can control how and when exceptions are thrown in your code.